And I support it. And I support it because we have great needs in our city. We have a lot of deferred maintenance. We have buildings that are falling apart. We need to continue to pave our streets. We need to do the maintenance in our parks so that they are safe for our children. And for all of these needs, I support the infrastructure bond. The second part of the question was, did I support Measure M? Yes, I supported Measure M. Measure M is why you see all these streets around town getting paved. What an extraordinary, wonderful thing that is. And had it not been for Measure M, we would not have been able to accelerate the rate at which we were paving. So yes, I support Measure M and I support T1. Thank you.
I don't support T1 at all. It's a blank check. I was at a forum the other day when Laura Capitelli was asked specifically what Measure T1 was going to fund. And he said, we don't know yet. We'll figure that out afterwards. He said, we'll figure it out. We'll make some committees. Well, you know, Measure M was passed because we knew what it was going to fund. E1 is passed because we knew what it was going to fund. You folks are smart. You folks are educated. You folks pay attention to the issues. You deserve a right to have a vote in these issues. Measure T1 is a 30-year bond where we can buy bonds at any point over the next 30 years. Interest rates are low right now, we've been told, so we should borrow a lot of money right now. But we aren't going to borrow a lot of money right now. We're going to borrow little bits and dribs and drabs over time. It's capped at 6% right now. But I'm not convinced the council won't be able to change that. I believe that we need to have real democracy and that you need to vote on these issues. And so I am adamantly opposed to T1. We have enough debt. We need to now start allocating our resources better.
Like Mr. Dodsworth, I also am opposing T1. I'll tell you why. There is nobody in the city that has written more about infrastructure than myself. I have written many, many op-eds in Berkeleyside, in various different places and different venues about our infrastructure woes. We have approximately $550 million in infrastructure needs. Now the problem with this bond, the problem with this measure, is that it doesn't specify how the money is going to be spent. What we really need is a comprehensive plan about how we're going to tackle our infrastructure needs. It's not a good idea just to kind of throw money at the wall and hope that something will be fixed. We really need a plan. And one of the problems in our city is that we always have a lack of transparency and accountability. And what we really need to see is how is this money going to be spent? So for example, we have $120 million in unfunded parks repairs alone. We have $70 million in unfunded streets repairs alone. Just to get the streets up to good shape would cost $70 million. So, plus there are many, many other things I'm not even mentioning, like the pools and our old city hall. So what I would really, really like to see, or to have seen, and I would have actually even voted for a much higher bond, is specifically, what is the city planning to do with our money? And also, how much of this is going to be spent on personnel? Our personnel costs are huge. And I think we have a right to know how much is being spent on personnel. My time is up, but I'll get to try to squeeze in my feelings about Measure M next time. Thanks.
They're around to do. I would ask that, I have no problem with polite applause after a candidate's made a statement, but let's keep it quiet during the talk just so that everyone can hear if that's okay. Thank you.